Hello students, myself Ms. Rachna Jain, Associate Professor, Department of English, Government PG College, Rajgarh, Alwar. Today I am going to teach you the four lines short poem of Kalidas, which is in the syllabus of Day Part 3, English Literature Paper 1st. Today's topics of my video lecture are Introduction to the poet Kalidas, his major works, his poem, is poetry always worthy when it is old, and the explanation of the poem with context. I give you a brief introduction of the poet Kalidas. Kalidas was a renowned Sanskrit poet and dramatist. He lived from the mid-4th to the early 5th century. He is regarded as the greatest person in classic Sanskrit literature. Based on tradition, it is represented that he was an illiterate person till by the favor of goddess he suddenly found himself endowed with the poetic genius. His birthplace possibly was somewhere in Malwa in center India. He described great praise of Ujjaini, so it is guessed that he was a resident of Ujjaini. The current legends are that he was a court poet of Vikramaditya of Ujjaini. His works show his profound acquaintance about court life. He was a Brahmin by caste and was a devout worshipper of Lord Shiva. He described vividly the Himalayan scenes in his works, so it is concluded that he had travelled far and wide throughout the country. The name of Kalidas itself means that he was a servant of the goddess Kali. His famous works. Kalidas wrote some plays, dramas such as Abhigyan Shankundalam, Malvika Agnimitram, Vikramarvarshiyam. He also wrote some great epic poems such as Raghuvansham and Kumar Sambhava and some Khand Kavyas such as Ritusanharam and Meghduta. Now I give you the brief story of his works. First of all, his dramas, Abhigyan Shakuntalam. Abhigyan Shakuntalam is the greatest drama composed by Kalidas. This drama describes the romantic love and the adversity of a maiden Shakuntala whom King Dushyant marries. The king, under a magic effect, forgets his bride, and when the ring which was given by him to her is discovered in the body of a fish, then he remembers her. So this play is very popular throughout the world. His second play is Malvika Agnimitram. It tells the story of a king Agnimitra, who falls in love with the picture of an excellent servant girl named Malvika. But when the queen discovers her husband's passion for this girl, she becomes infuriated and has Malvika imprisoned. But as fate would have it, Malvika is in fact a true-born princess, thus legitimizing the affair. In the third play, Vikramarvarshiyam, This play tells the story of immortal king Pururvas and the celestial nymph Urvashi who fall in love. As an immortal, Urvashi has to return to the heavens where an unfortunate accident causes her to be sent back to the earth as a mortal with the curse that she will die and thus return to heaven. The moment her lover lays his eyes on the child which will bear him, and after a series of mishappenings including Urvashi's temporary transformation into a vine, the curse is lifted and the lovers are allowed to remain together on the earth. Then the epic poems Raghuvansha. Raghuvansha is an epic poem about the kings of the Raghu dynasty. Second epic poem is Kumarsambhava. It describes the birth and the adolescence of goddess Parvati and her marriage with Lord Shiva. Then the Khand Kavyas. First is Ritusanhar. It describes the six seasons by narrating the experiences of two lovers in each of the season. And then Meghduta. It is the story of Yaksh who tries to send the message to his beloved through a cloud. So these are the famous works of Kalidas. Now I read you the poem which I am going to teach you in detail. Is poetry always worthy when it is old, and is worthless then because it's new? Reader, decide yourself if this be true. Fool, suspend judgment, waiting to be told. This poem is composed by Kalidas and translated by John Gruff into English. In the first line, the poet asks a question: is poetry always worthy when it is old? Worthy means significant. The poet asks a question whether poetry is always worthy when it is old, because poetry stands the test of time. That is, when time does not affect the worth of poetry. It signifies that poetry has real and intrinsic worth in it. In the second line, he asks another question: and is worthless then because it's new. The question is that whether poetry becomes worthless due to being new. So there are two questions. First is whether poetry is always significant when it becomes old, or it is worthless because it is new. Reader, decide yourself if this be true. So the poet leaves this question to be decided by a sensible reader whether it is true or not. Fool, suspend judgment, waiting to be told. And the poet finally says that the foolish persons or dull readers do not decide it themselves, but leave it to be decided by other persons and tell the decision of it to them. Foolish readers are unable to decide the worth of poetry, and they depend on critics or some other readers to tell them the worth or significance of poetry. Kalidas says that the judicious reader himself should decide if these are true or not. He himself should judge the worth of poetry. Only a fool will defer judgment and wait for some other readers or critics to tell and guide him about the real and intrinsic worth of poetry. So, these are the beautiful lines in which Kalidas puts the question and gives the decision. This stanza has been translated from Sanskrit into English by John Bruff. The rhyme scheme of this stanza is ABBA. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.